Hi, I'm Jack Lynas here in Torquay, ready to visit two of its most top attractions, Living Coasts and Paignton Zoo.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive.
Hey, this is Jack Lynas here, standing with the keepers to the zebra enclosure. We're just going to ask them some quick questions.
How often do they get fed, do you know?
Well, they get fed a small amount in the evenings, just to bring them in. But during the day, they're out grazing on the paddocks. They have a lot of grass, and it's just the grass all day. And then they get hay and dry feed in the evening.
Alright. So whereabouts would they live in the wild, then?
They're African animals, obviously. Botswana kind of area.
Right, so what's their general behaviour in the wild then? What do they act like?
They're quite flighty animals, groups. When they're in sort of being chased, they work together to get away from predators. And obviously their stripes are part of camouflage, so to confuse predators from a long distance. So they're very much a group animal. Obviously it's a bit different here, we've only got the three of them.
At the moment.
Yeah, but hopefully the idea is to get a few more. Get a bit more of a bigger herd.
Yeah. In the wild, of course, you probably get the Hartmans up to about 20 individual females. So you get the male. He's normally outside. He'll come in and mate, then he'll go out again. That's how they are in the wild. But say we try and represent it here. You'll find him. We'll let the females out. The male will always tend to keep his distance, won't he?
Yeah.
He'll come, then he'll go off again. You know, it's very similar to what they are in the wild.
All right.
A supersonic woman of you. Don't stop me, don't stop me, don't stop me.
Hey, hey, hey!
Don't stop me, don't stop me. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I like
don't stop
it.
Me, don't stop me.
I'm standing here with Jason. He's keeper of the lions and the rhinos enclosure. So I'm just going to ask you some quick questions.
Yep.
How long have you been working with the lions?
I've worked with the lions we have here now since they arrived, or in the female's case, she was born here. But I've worked with the lions here for approximately 21, 22 years now.
So, right. So what is their food like compared to the wild here?
Oh, it's still meat-based, which is, you know, it emulates a wild diet, but obviously they're not getting a large amount of live food. They do catch live food, they catch ducks and things like that, but what we give them is large bits of horse meat on the bone, whole carcasses like chickens, turkeys, rabbits. So we try and do as natural a feed as possible without putting in live pigs, and you know, because we can't, because it's illegal, of course. So.
All right. Yeah. How many times should you do that on a weekly basis?
We try and incorporate one or two staff days per week per animal in there, so that again tries to emulate natural. You know, they won't feed every day naturally anyway, although they'll be eating more than we feed them when we do feed them. So, yeah, it's not 100% natural, but we try to get it as natural as we can. So.
Okay, and now some questions for the rhinos.
Yep.
So, how long have you been working with the rhinos then?
I used to be the giraffe keeper, and I swapped the giraffes for the rhinos about 10 years ago. So, yeah, about right. 10 years. Yeah.
And what about their feeding? Is it different in the wild? Or
it is a little bit. It's only species-wise. I mean, again, we try and be as natural as we can. The black rhinos are browsing animals, so we give them browse every day of the year. In Africa, of course, they'd be eating things like acacia, which doesn't grow in the UK, but all the natural trees and stuff we have growing around here, they'll eat pretty much everything, whether it be oak, elm, willow, and the trick is to just vary it, so they're not having, you know, 2-3 days of consecutive oak or willow or whatever it might be. And there's only a few things we wouldn't feed, and that's the ones that are obviously poisonous or non-edible. So.
I'm standing here with Tom, keeper of the gorillas enclosure, and we're going to just go ask some quick fire questions. So how long have you been working with the gorillas?
With these gorillas, I've been working with them since last October, so not that long, but before that I was working at Jersey Zoo for 6 years with them.
Okay.
For a little while.
Okay, so what's the average lifespan for a gorilla?
Well, certainly in captivity they're going to live longer than they would in the wild, because they live quite a pampered life in the country.
How does their food compare to what it's like in the wild, so?
They would actually eat a bit more than they do in the wild,
but that's mainly because the food they get there is not as nutritionally rich as they get in captivity, so they tend to get less, but it's more nutrient rich.
Okay, is the environment similar or different compared to what it's like in the wild?
It's very difficult to recreate in captivity what they would have in the wild, just because by a gorilla's very nature it goes around tearing things apart and pulling plants up, and it's just not possible to do that in captivity unless you go out every day and plant new stuff. However, there are various ways which we can sort of replicate the behaviour they might carry out in the wild, such as providing them with climbing frames and deep litter, which we can hide a lot of food in, so they spend a lot of time foraging. Also, the actual makeup of the group is very important because they're very sociable animals. So it's very important that you get that setup right, because you know, they require a lot of interaction with each other. They're very sociable. So as long as you get that, you're winning half the argument, basically.
Do you think it's right to keep them in captivity, or do you think they should be left in the wild?
I think, if you think about it, the most dangerous place for a gorilla to be at the moment is in Africa. Mm. That's not to say that they shouldn't be there, because you know, that's where they come from. And as much as we can, we should be protecting them out there. Whether they should be in captivity or not, I think they're sort of representatives for their wild cousins. And I think if we can get visitors in to come and see them in captivity, then we can show them what magnificent animals they are. And this hopefully will have an effect on the visitor, so they might be able to do something about it themselves, like get more involved with conservation. It's all about getting that message across so that we can help them, so we encourage everybody to help them in the wild.